Now, next day, one cylinder head here, the other cylinder head. Usually I'm not showing you this, but screw it, I'm gonna show you. Yeah, okay. This process now, I'm spending almost an hour on each cylinder head. Why I'm doing that? This is for me purely, some people they're gonna say, what in hell are you doing? But this is for me to have a peace of mind and to be everything fine. This involves a couple of tools, all right? Brake cleaner, degreaser, and brake cleaner at the same time, rag, Dremel, why I'm calling Dremel anyhow? We have the accelerator pedal here and... All right, so what's the point here? I take care of some things, like let us say here it was from the casting was not okay, here it was not okay, external, this is mostly cosmetic, don't cut your hands, your gloves if you like, some sharp corners, removing the carbon from the fuel injector hole here, like you see yesterday, I take care about this one. Then, inside the combustion chamber, there are some imperfections. Not always, in some cases. Okay, and that's why I have also this. This is later, not now, in any case. Okay, I saw before that there is one imperfection somewhere. It's a small one, it's not affecting anything, I don't want to be there. There is... Shit, I cannot find it now. Oh boy. There is this one. This small thing down there. It's a bit more high. That on the other cylinders, it's not existing. And then you can see here, there is a mark. But here it's not existing. Here it's not existing, and here there is a mark. So this, some of them are gonna get polished. On this one, I'm gonna make it exactly as this next to it, to be like that. If it makes sense, if you understand what I'm saying and what I'm showing, talking about this small piece here. So then, on the ports, you see this port. This is nice. It looks okay, right? Here, there is this stupid thing, one here and one there inside. Here, there is this stupid thing. Here, there is, one second now. Yeah, all these things, what you see, it's chips, it's from grinding. That's why I said that this is the first wash yesterday. So, whatever imperfection has a cylinder head, that's what I'm taking care about it now. Even the coolant path. And there is also another one that I'm always cleaning it in all of the cylinder heads. It's this one here. This, because from it's like a lip, this one. It's very thin. You're gonna see later. You're gonna see later. Screw it. Since I show you this, I'm gonna show you completely how we're gonna do it. Let me finish with this cylinder head. After that, brake cleaner blowing with air, not washing it again. I have to care also all these things here inside from the casting. This step to be nice. Brake cleaner blowing with air outside, not here inside the engine room. I'm gonna vacuum all these things with a vacuum cleaner, then lapping the valves and then washing it for final. That's the procedure, my procedure. Now you do whatever you like. So now see here how it is, and here see the difference how it is if I don't touch it. Alright, this on the casting. Do not attempt to do that if you don't know what you're doing, because there is an oil gallery here and there is an oil gallery here. So if you eat too much, you maybe can open a hole and can escape the oil from that side. So what's the point here? Intake valve spring. Alright, see how near it is to the casting, to the sharp corner there. All right, on the high mileage M157, you see it's almost touching. Down there has a washer and it can make this move, the spring, the valve spring. So, let me tell you this. On a high mileage M157, the valve spring does have the same tension, all right? It can hit the wall. It won't destroy the spring, because simply the spring is much more hard than the aluminum. This is very soft, actually. The thing is that it's gonna produce some chips. All these stupid things that has, it's gonna end up to be inside of the engine. So, and you'll get it turned down, then you're gonna pick up from the pickup tube, and these kind of small things, it can be sucked through the screen of the pickup tube. So, what I'm doing, this I'm doing it for a long life of the engine, to don't have any problem, don't have any garbage inside or something like that. It's not a must, me I'm doing it. Plus, if you see the valve spring at 3500 RPMs, 3500 RPMs of the camshaft, 7000 RPMs on the crankshaft down, at 7000 RPMs, you'll gonna see it's not steady, it's not compressed in and out. It can make this movement left and right, up, front and back, you know. It's not gonna be exactly on the same position and moving there. So to have so tight clearance all around, it's not the best thing. So it can make, let us say, this move when it's working, all right? Because there is a space also. It has also the space to do that. It's not only that. If you want my opinion, this seat down there where it's sitting the valve spring, it can be a bit more tight since you have tight clearance here. So what I'm doing, like always, I'm not showing you, because again, if you make one mistake here, we can open a hole. Compare this one, let us say, how it does looks like this one. Alright. This one that has, it looks a little bit out, this is the design. This is here and this is here. That's why I'm not eating it more. It's fine there where it is. The same thing also here. Here you can see from the factory that they machine it for the valve spring, but there are the two corners, one left, one right. You can clearly see there, but here it's not existing. Here I didn't finish. I'm continuing here actually. After that I have this one and this one. From this side, same thing. If you get, let us say, the exhaust valve spring, you need to break the corners. Give me a second. Exhaust valve spring, put it back in place. Okay, so you see that's very near to the corners here and here. So this corner here need to go away, this corner here need to go away, and you're okay from here. I don't care for the casting here up that looks like garbage. Okay, honestly, it's very high and it's not affecting anything. It doesn't make any difference if I clear, let us say, the casting here up. Here doesn't matter. What matters on these sharp edges, on these sharp points, there. It's very tight on the M157. This I'm gonna keep it here because I have to wash it. Don't put it with the rest. It's a little bit tight. That's the design of the head. What can you do, right? Overall, I already fixed a couple of spots that I found to be nice, like here, let us say, on the other ports didn't have any problems from the, now don't to move the cylinder head from the carton, because all these things what you see inside, it'll gonna get sucked. I'm not gonna blow it first, I'm gonna suck it to go away, then with a brake cleaner, and then that's why I'm gonna continue with the final wash because of all this. Unfortunately, I'm not able to remove the ball from here because this is the oil gallery that comes here. Pay attention, another one thing, I'm not installing the check valve. The check valve that will gonna come here, it's gonna be the last thing I'm gonna install. If I install now here the check valve is one way. That means it can supply oil to the tensioner, but it cannot return back the pressure. If it stuck something on the ball that has inside on the spring, any of these small things, it won't gonna work. It's gonna be pointless and maybe it's gonna glock even the path. So this is the oil gallery, what you see. That's a straight line from here, and then there is another one that you can see has one ball here, and if you follow the route, it comes back here at this point. So if I blow it, if I now make the mistake and I start blowing inside, all this garbage is gonna get stuck here on the ball, at the edge of the ball, and I don't know when and if they go away, let us say in the future, and gonna clog any hydraulic lifter. That's the reason why I'm sucking first. That's why it's completely dry. It does have oil, the cylinder head on it. It's totally dry, so don't get stuck anything on it. At the end, first sucking all these pieces from inside, then with a brake cleaner, blowing it again and again, and then with detergent, at the end, one final wash. That's the final wash. I already removed the sealant from all over the place. There is no sealant anywhere on the walls, here between or something, to be nice and clean. You can see that's a little bit different color here because I'm using this one to take care about the sealant at this point here to get away. Smoothing out with some small stones, plastic brushes like this, with a brake cleaner for the fuel injector holes from where it's passing. You get the picture, right? So again, if you want my opinion, do not attempt to do that. If you haven't used Dremel before, if you're not familiar, it's very tight, the clearance here inside. You can destroy the guide, you can open a hole, let us see, on the oil gallery. It's not for everybody. You need to be to feel comfortable to do that. Worst case scenario, you can open a hole, like I said, on the oil gallery, you can destroy the surface of the head, and then good luck. Let's move on. Okay, now I have started with the exhaust from the intake. I'm fine. It's okay from the intake. Now the exhaust, like I said before, the corners, I have break the corners here, 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 and here. You can see there, you can see here, you can see here. So in this valve here, I haven't break the corner. You can see how sharp it is down there. And from this side I already did it. Yay. Okay, let's see this one. That's not been, I didn't touch it. This is happening, like I said before, it comes, let us say, the tool inside to machine it, and when it's entering inside, whatever it grabs the tool, it's removing it. That's why you see this line here. So unfortunately, it's exactly where is the half, let us say. That's why you see the casting here, that's outside, that's the molding. Actually, you can see where, you can show, you know, it's like, not like this, I already fixed it. I'm gonna show you the other thing here. I'm talking about this line that has usually on the casting, and also inside. You can compare this one. You can see the sharp edges there, 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 there. You can see the sharp edge here. It looks like, if you like, that's been, it's half piece, if it makes sense, what I'm trying to say. So that's why also you can see inside. I'll show you this. You see down there, there is some burn oil. I didn't clean it very well. Why I didn't clean it very well? May I have to rewash it again? Here, I don't care so much here inside. I do care, the first wash, like I said, I do care to remove all the carbon from the valve guides, from the compression chamber here, the ports, to be nice and clean. And then on the final wash, all this will get away. Even anything, all the rest, all right? So for now, let's continue with that. It's not going to be more weak, the cylinder head, by any means. Actually, it's gonna be, if you like, it's gonna be more strong, not more weak. When you have a unfinished corner and you have a sharp, it's more weak than when you polish it, if it makes any sense. For example, let me get as example, all right? I have this aluminum bracket. If there are some scratches, let us say here, and I try to bend it, where are the scratches? There will gonna be the weak point. If I polish it, it won't have a weak point. It's gonna break, let us say, somewhere else. If that's making sense to you. So that's it. Much continue. Did I fix something here I didn't show you earlier? This piece here, I take care about it. If you put your finger, it's exactly the same like the one next to it. Beautiful. And there was another two spots, one there inside there. It's not porting by any means, it's not polishing or something, just only take care of the imperfections. And the setup that I'm gonna make on this M157, it's gonna be exactly the same setup what I did on the GLE, what I did on the E63, the 4MATIC. By the way, the G63 with our turbo upgrade, it makes 950 wheel horsepower. It's 4MATIC, 953, something like that. It has some crazy numbers on Draghi. Anyhow, let's continue. Now,
finish with the cylinder head. I have to continue with the other one. Unfortunately, there are two, okay? And you see that there are no sharp corners anymore where it's located the valve spring. Beautiful. One small thing that I'm doing that doesn't matter, it's not affecting. This is not gonna give you power, this is not gonna give you nothing. This is me and my stupid brain, my head, that I want to be like this. This is happening because it didn't touch human hand on this. This is only, let us say, machining the head, and then he get the other guy and he installing it, and that's it. So there are some small imperfections for me, for my eyes, for my mind. Maybe I'm crazy, that's a different story. Anyhow, so like I said, I didn't make it a week at all. There's no problem at all. One of the reasons that I was not putting it on the video is because of the oil galleries and because of the Dremel, call it as you like. I make mistake. Anyhow, and it's not the best. I mean, if you make, I think that I touch somewhere. Yes, I think, you see, I touch here. I make two lines here, but doesn't matter because here comes O-ring in the middle. So yes, I touch here. I'm sorry, you know, maybe I can touch, let's say, in the other one, in the same spot. I haven't touched anywhere else. All the rest is beautiful. If you're not careful, I have done this 1,000,000 times. I'm using Dremel, I don't remember, 20 years probably. If you're not careful, you're losing the game. Okay, you have the valve guide, you have the location where it's the hydraulic lifter, you have here where it's stepping the camshaft, you have the surface here that seals with the sealant, you have the oil gallery, like I said. If you're not feeling comfortable, don't do it. If you think that's not necessary, do not do it. It doesn't mean that it's right, okay? For me, it's right. For somebody else, it's not right. That's what I have to say. So, now, Mr. Omar, vacuum cleaner. Omar! Now, it's a little bit funny because I'm putting the vacuum cleaner over there and I bring the pipe inside the engine room and I'm sagging while it's there and the vacuum cleaner is outside. Can you please bring me, are you? Okay, please bring me the, no, are you? Listen 1 second, the vacuum cleaner I need. The vacuum cleaner, the big vacuum cleaner. Bring it here, please. Yeah, we didn't find Omar, we found you. With the vacuum cleaner, sucking these stupid things that has inside now. And then brake cleaner, blowing it. Lapping the valves continue actually with the rest of the job. You already know that. Yeah. I'm gonna make also a joke now to the owner. I'm gonna send him a message now. I'm gonna tell him that his cylinder head is gone. And then when he sees the video, he'll gonna understand it was a joke. I'm an asshole, eh?
The vacuum machine?
The vacuum cleaner. Oh. Bring it here outside, please. Oh boy, why I have to fucking repeat myself 50 times. Okay. Yes, what I was saying? Yeah, let's make a joke. It's 12:20. I don't know what time it's gonna be in his country, but anyhow, in Canada. Yep. How should they? Now, after cleaning it, looking good, looking beautiful. Looking excellent. Now that's what I like, to be nice and smooth here. And to don't have the sharp corners, and to have a bit more room for the valve spring. Excellent. Now you can tell me how I did it, right? Okay. Vacuum cleaner. On this one, that I'm pushing it to be round. I have a reason why I'm making it round. On both motors, I have this funnel that I'm putting the vacuum here and I'm start sucking now, I touch it and I have to go. No, I don't have to do anything because I'm not gonna touch the other cylinder head. I have first this funnel and then I have this funnel that I'm putting on top. You can see the pieces actually. And then I'm start sucking. This one, this pipe, it matches perfectly where are the hydraulic lifters, where they're located, the hydraulic lifters. So inside one at a time, because the oil gallery, it's at this point here. So usually when I'm cleaning here, it fells down like that, it doesn't fell inside. You can see that's nice and clean inside, and you can see that it's nice and clean inside, nice and shiny. And you can see even from here that all the way from here till the end, as much as you can see actually, it's nice and clean. I have also laser, I have a green and red laser that I can put inside and I can see. I'm not gonna show you that, screw it, I already show you so many things today. Let's continue with this cylinder head. So let's see this one. This is the intake, all right? That's the intake from this side. And that's the intake from that side. You can tell me you choose the worst one, eh? No, there is also worst here. There is also here. There is also this sharp over here. In all of them. You get the picture now? There is also this that's sharp. This one you can remove at least 1 millimeter from here. Same thing here. Same thing here. Same thing here. All right, let's continue. Have to clean the carton. And yes, then put the other cylinder head on it. Don't put it on these things. Continue. I have to put a little bit far away that one, to don't be near. Yeah, continue, go ahead. And this one, don't forget to do here, this. Sometimes I'm forgetting, that's why. Now, also the other cylinder head ready. I remove the sealant from everywhere. There is nowhere sealant. I already fix the window here, where is the valve spring. Has enough clearance, left and right. It's not like before. Whoever opened valve springs on the M157, you know that when you get the valve spring compressor tool and you try to insert it inside, it's hitting sometimes left and right, especially on the exhaust, because it's smaller. Before I fixed that one, 6-7 years ago, I fixed this one. That I cut like this to be able to put inside. That's why I have it from one side square here to match this. Anyhow, so done. I already increased also the diameter of the hole here, where is the coolant path. Before it was smaller, now it's how it's supposed to be. Alright. There was one imperfection here on the casting, another one here had disappeared. Beautiful, excellent. Now it came the time to count the valves and then count also the cylinder head. It should be fine, it doesn't have any problem. Both cylinder heads are excellent. This is a marks from the brake cleaner. That's why you see like this. This one and this one. All this will gonna disappear on the last wash. Beautiful, beautiful, excellent, amazing. So let's put back the valve spring. Let's count the valves. See where are we. Yep. Which cylinder head I have now here? This is the driver's side. This is the bank two, driver's side. There you go. So I have to wash a little bit, because since yesterday, keep this on side, washing a little bit and then counting it. Continue. Okay, what I'm doing now, I'm counting the valves. You see how sensitive it is. If I move the table, changing all the story. So this is the valve. This is the black spot where I'm counting, 3.370. This is, by the way, this is this valve. Just give me a second. It's counting in millimeters, by the way. What does mean that one? This valve, sorry, 3.375, 5,000 of millimeter higher this one than this one. So this, what you see, it doesn't step down. The valve stepping down. What I mean by that? Let me remove it. I have to be careful, don't destroy the needle. It's sensitive. Okay, yeah, stay there. What I mean by that, this is the valve, and this sits like this on the cylinder head, and this you can see that's a little bit higher. It's by 0.2 of a millimeter higher. My point here is I want to count from the valve to this one to see the difference, how much the height. So this is matching also for the exhaust valves, intake valves, M156, M157, that's why I have this one. So then another measurement. Sometimes I'm counting also the total height of the valve. I'm just putting in the middle and total height. And then this one is to count the wait. I'm gonna do it now. Yeah, how nice. I put the camera on the bracket. Then I get the bracket with the camera together with the mobile. Okay. Just a second. I'm done. Okay. So I'm counting the valve in 3 points. Leave it there. So 5964. I'm counting it here in the middle and down here where has I wear. I'm writing down the numbers. These valves are gonna be used again on the same spot as it was running all the time. Counting it, taking also the clearance that's given to me, the valve guide, do the homework, you know, classic, like all the time, and then moving on. Three measurements on each valve. One measurement, okay, I did it. Actually, I don't have to touch it here. I'm touching it usually from down here when I'm counting here. Three measurements. One measurement from here where it sits till the top, then 1, 2, 3 here, and one you can make in total how much it is. I have also another measurement. I'm putting it here, I'm putting this needle, and then I'm putting the valve lie down like that, and then I'm taking, at this point I'm talking about, it matches beautiful here on this stand I'm talking about. But that's a different story. Anyhow, same things like usual, like always. The valves are excellent, they don't have any problem. From the driver's side, we are good to go. I was not expecting something different, to be honest with you. And like I said also before, because the owner, he told me, how do I know that his engine has 100,000 kilometers? The wear, what I see here on the cylinder heads, on the valves, and on the engine in general, it gives me the feeling that doesn't have more than 100,000 kilometers. That's, maybe I'm wrong, but that's how I feel. I mean for the wear. This I can wash a little bit better, eh? It's not the best. All right, no worries. Now, lapping it. To make it nice again. Take it about the tools, because I'm gonna finish with the driver's side, and then I'm gonna continue with the passenger side. And now, Tassos, have fun. Oh boy. I finished this one. You know what's the problem with this? I'm never using this one, the course. I'm using always the fine. And from one side it's full, from the other side it's empty. Now, getting the tools, I already mount the inlet valves with the paste here. Start lapping it with this order. All right, we have the driver's side, we have the intake, boom. The timer, 30 seconds I'm gonna give only for the intake, because it looks beautiful. I'm gonna double check it. We need also the petrol. I already bring fresh petrol. Don't throw it down with one hand. We stay where you are. And one rag to clean. I have one here. Okay. One rag to see the progress. Okay. This no need. This is going. Yeah, I'm gonna throw it now. It's not about the money, it's about that there is material inside that I can't use it anywhere. Stuffing. Yeah. Should I finish it here? No, I'm gonna show you first one exhaust and one intake valve, and then. Okay, lapping the first valve. Look beautiful, looking excellent. 30 seconds only. I was not expecting something less than this. I was expecting that need only, and this is a special tool also, this is for the lifters, for the M156. So, there you go. Now you see why I have to rewash again the cylinder head for final, because of all this paste. First I'm wiping out carefully with the petrol. I'm soaking one rag inside of the petrol and carefully I'm wiping out, because if you push it, you're gonna start lapping it again to don't destroy the seat. It's not so easy, it's very hard, but I'm, you know, take care about this. And then it's going for the final wash. Yeah, let's continue also with the rest. I'm gonna stop the video now here. I'm gonna continue on Saturday. I'm gonna continue now lapping the valves. I'm gonna continue counting the other valves, bring also the other cylinder head here. I'm gonna show you the progress on Saturday. Tomorrow we have off, Friday off, Saturday back. So this valve is beautiful. It can go back in place. This is front. That was the last one. Yes, beautiful. What else? I want to upload the video because I make a joke to the customer. I said to him that there is a problem with your cylinder head. So I want to upload the video to don't to don't think that there is a problem. That it is just Tassos and his black humor. That's it. So thank you very much. Have a nice weekend. See you again on Saturday.